Hello guys, welcome to today's lecture. In today's lecture we will discuss about the engine power. In this lecture we will see the various engine terminologies, as well we will solve some problems and we will see how the power at different points is measured in the engine. So before starting video, we will solve this problem, and such simple problems have been asked in exams in GRF as well as MCRCET. So I'll just read here problem. If the IHP is 17.2 kilowatt, then the mechanical efficiency is 76%, then what will be the BHP of the engine? So the answer will be among these four, and we will see what is IHP, what is BHP, what is mechanical efficiency, and how they are interrelated. So we will see it all details in the lecture. Before starting to the engine powers, some basic terminologies are important to study the engine power. First one is bore. So guys, the diameter of the cylinder is expressed as bore. So this is a cylinder, and what is the diameter of this cylinder is called as bore. Then stroke. Stroke is a length which is expressed in mm or centimeter. It is the distance traveled by the piston. So the distance between TDC to the BDC is called as stroke. Then stroke bore ratio. Here guys, the stroke and bore, you know, bore, stroke is stroke length, so from distance from TDC to BDC, and bore is cylinder diameter. So stroke bore ratio is ratio of stroke length to the cylinder diameter. Next one is swept volume. The volume displaced by the piston is called as swept volume. So at the suction stroke, the cylinder comes down to the BDC. When it comes down to the BDC, some air is sucked in the cylinder, so some volume is created here. But when in compression section, from BDC piston moves to TDC, then the amount of volume is displaced by piston, means this volume is displaced to this. This volume is called as swept volume. The swept volume is the volume present in this hollow section when piston is at TDC. So when piston is at TDC, whatever the volume the cylinder head will possess of fuel or charge is called as swept volume. It is expressed in A into L. So A is the cross sectional area of the cylinder head and L is stroke length. So pardon me, the swept volume is total volume displaced by the piston, and clearance volume is this. The remaining portion's volume is called clearance volume, and whatever the volume displaced by piston is called as swept volume. Then compression ratio, it's the ratio of cylinder volume to the clearance volume. So total cylinder volume divided by clearance volume. Clearance volume is this one. Total cylinder volume to clearance volume, the ratio will be called as compression ratio. But the total cylinder volume is the summation of this is swept volume and this is clearance volume. So we can express compression ratio as swept volume plus clearance volume divided by clearance volume. The many simple questions has been asked. If you know swept volume and the compression ratio, what will be the clearance volume? And we will know, if you know clearance volume and compression ratio, find the swept volume. Such simple MCQs has been asked. So just remember this terminology and try to solve some 1-2 example on this concept. Then power. Power is rate of doing work of the engine. So at how much rate the work is done in engine is called as power, and it is expressed in watt. So SI unit of power is watt. Now we will turn to power section. So guys, engine obviously convert the mechanical energy into the it converts heat energy into the mechanical energy. So we can observe the power of the engine at various points. like at the brakes, at engine cylinder, at piston, at drawbars, or at belt or pulley. All these points are checkpoints where the engine power can be measured. So according to that, the power has been named. First one we will see the IHP, indicated horsepower. It is the power generated in the cylinder engine and received by the piston. So here it is developed without friction or auxiliary unit. And whatever the engine power we consider, that is IHP. There is one formula to compute the IHP. In SI unit, IHP is plan PLAN divided by 60 into 10 raised to 12 into x raised to 12. So what is P? P is a mean effective pressure, which is expressed in kg per centimeter square. In SI unit, it is expressed in Pascal. L is length of stroke, which is measured in mm as well as meter. And A is cross sectional area of piston. It is expressed in mm square as well as centimeter square. At last, the x is the number of cylinder, and according to 4 stroke we will divide it by 2 or 1 in 2 stroke and 4 stroke engine. So this is formula for IHP in SI unit, and this is formula of IHP in metric unit. We mostly use the IHP formula in metric unit. So simple questions here also form: what is mean effective pressure? If all the rest things has been given, IHP is given, length of stroke is given, cross sectional area of piston given, and number of cylinders are given, we have to find out mean effective pressure, or we have to compute the IHP if rest of the things has been given. Also one interesting question we will discuss at last. Then brake horsepower. It is the power delivered by engine and it is available at end of crankshaft. So whatever power we will experience at the end of the crankshaft is called as brake horsepower. It has relation with mechanical efficiency and IHP. So brake horsepower divided by IHP is termed as mechanical efficiency. So we have to compute the BHP by multiplying mechanical efficiency to IHP. So this is the derivation of BHP or brake horsepower. After that it comes belt power. It is the power of engine and measured at the end of the suitable belt, which is driven by PTO shaft. So it is the power of engine and it is measured at PTO shaft. So it is called as belt power. Suitable belt is driven by PTO shaft. It is also very similar to power takeoff power or PTO power. It is power delivered at tractor through its PTO shaft. The belt and PTO power of tractor will be approximately same. So belt power and PTO power are approximately same. Then DBHP. DBHP is called as drawbar horsepower. The drawbar is extension provided at tractor to attach the implements. So whatever the power experienced by drawbar at the end of the tractor is called as drawbar horsepower. So it is the power of the tractor measured at the end of the drawbar. We have seen PTO power or power takeoff power. So these were some simple power terms and engine terminologies. Now actually we will solve two problems. First one we have seen before starting our lecture. If the IHP is 17.2 kilowatt and the mechanical efficiency is 76%, what will be the BHP of the engine? And the answer is option B. We will see the solution. So guys, here we know the mechanical efficiency has relation that it is ratio of BHP and IHP. We will convert the mechanical efficiency into numeric from percentage. So 0.76 will be the mechanical efficiency. Now BHP is equal to, we will take this IHP to this side, so it will be multiply to mechanical efficiency. So we will get the actual value of 13.36, and which is very near to our option B. So option B, 13 kilowatt is correct answer. Again, here it is one interesting problem. We will, such problems actually ask in GRF exam. So how many times the power of the engine increases or decreases if the diameter of the piston is increased by 20%? So here diameter is increased by 20% and the stroke length is reduced to 20%. Stroke length is reduced to 20%. All factors remaining the same. So guys, we know the formula of IHP. Here P L A what has been asked in this last question. We will express length, reduce length by 20% and raise the diameter of the piston by 20%. So it is let P1 is equal to normal and so P2 is equal to new IHP. So new IHP, the L will be 0.8 and in area of the cross sectional area of piston, the diameter will be 1.2 as it is raising from 0.20%. So it is very interesting problem. It is for assignment to you and you will get this problem in Jagdishwar Sahai book, problem number 4.9. So the answer will be of new power 1.152 times. So that was about today's lecture. These are our channels to connect with us. Thank you.